Sunday, August 30th, 2009. And this is your Daily Dose. I fixed Saturday's video, so it's up and running too. So if you didn't get to see it yesterday, by all means, make sure you go back and watch that after this. Also today, I know this is a little late, but run out and get today's paper because in the living section, there's an article posted. And this is what we're going to be talking about big time tomorrow. I'm going to read a little, a few excerpts from it here in a second. Also, in another area of the paper, I can't remember which section I took this from, but Utah police bust huge pot farm. Another article to read. No quotes today. I'm not even going to lie. I've been upset all day. I've been trying to stay medicated, stay calm as best I can. Article here about how to get your card, so on and so forth, basically. It's written by Corey Levitan. There's a quote right here on the beginning. For marijuana to work, the patient would have to be stoned around the clock. And this is a guy, Dr. Kent Wellish. Sorry, ophthalmologist, sir, but I believe that there's people that would disagree with you that are just as educated, even if just by their title. It also talks about how there's a cancer doctor in here. Don't worry, I'm going to do some more research on this, but I can't believe this. It talks about Dr. Michaels mentions in the article. I can't wait to break this apart for you guys. I'm going to spend a whole week on this article, I think, just going over different parts of it. I don't even know how to take it. But I'm going to just give you guys, here's what I'm going to focus on tomorrow. And I'm just going to read this one paragraph. And it says, the only legal ways for cardholders in Nevada to begin growing, according to the Metropolitan Police Department, Public Information Officer Barbara Morgan, are to purchase an ounce or less of seeds from another country via the internet, or to obtain, I'm going to stop at that comma because it doesn't matter what happens after that. Purchase an ounce or less of seeds from another country via the internet? Are they trying to lead the lambs to the slaughter? Really? Did she check with our government or the Fed to see if that was even allowed? I'm not saying it can't be done. I'm just saying Metro shouldn't be having patients led to believe that this is legal behavior that they can do. Now it goes on to say via the internet or to obtain seeds or a cutting from another plant for free from another cardholder. Don't worry, we're going to take this apart even more. But here's another part that's going to get attacked. And this is what, it talks about police officers, so on and so forth. Even if patients don't have their cards on them, they're not arrested. And this is what I need to research some more because I believe this is incorrect. Because the DMV notes their existence in its computer record. Now, they might note the existence, but we need to find out if that's something that shows up just on a random license plate check. Because that's a health information, and it's not something that needs to be out there unless it's necessary for the resolution of a legal matter or an issue at that time. So I'm going to do some research on that. This is where I'm so heated and why I'm so unfocused and I haven't been able to get it right today. Even if patients don't have their cards, they're not arrested because the DMV notes are blah, blah, blah. And then it says this, and this is written by Corey Levitan. It says, this begs the question of how many, if any, medical marijuana patients are actually illegal drug users who exaggerate or fake medical symptoms to get impunity for their habit. Wow. And then the last part it says, and I'll get onto this some more too, we'll talk about it. When asked for her take, Officer Morgan, who by the way is the, let me go back to her title there, I believe it said Public Service, Metropolitan Department Public Information Officer Barbara Morgan. So it says, when asked for her take, Officer Morgan replied, all we do is enforce the law. We can't personally have our opinions. That may be true when it comes to enforcing the law. But if you're in law enforcement and you're enforcing a law that you know is dumb, that is costing taxpayers money, you should be speaking up as a citizen. That's your civic duty. We pay taxes to pay yourself. You pay your own salary. It's just terrible to think that this is even happening. information officer. She's not allowed to have her opinion. Not that we even really care what her opinion is. The point being is if... Oh, don't worry. We're going to go over this article some more. I promise. Get out and get a copy of it. If not, come down to the office. I'll be more than happy to burn you off some copies. Right now, I would like you to... Where's it at? I'm going to go ahead and give you the phone number. If you've read this article or you need to read this article, please remember, contact Corey Levitan at clevitan@reviewjournal.com or 702-383-0456. Once again, not a single mention of the medical cannabis consultants. I'm sorry, I just don't have money to play with the people that are gouging patients $200 to $300 on top of the required fees, like it says here in the article. Like, it just baffles me. But I can't stand by it any longer. Funguses and bacteria grow on plants very easily. Wow. Are you really serious, doctor? Really? You're that smart? You're that smart and you're worried about funguses and bacteria? Well, how about I read off the list of side effects for the drugs that you do support? Golly, sometimes I can't believe we have such smart people that are so damn stupid. It makes me sick. I'm tired of it. You're going to hear about this article all week. Sorry that it took so long to get this video up. We're going to start ruffling some feathers now because I cannot tolerate people that are supposed to be intelligent and respected in their fields making statements like what have been made. So keep in tune for this week. I got a feeling it's going to be an eventful week. I'm tired of reading and seeing the people that are making the news on this issue. We're going to have to change that. This was Sunday, August 30th, 2009, and this was your Daily Dose. Get a Sunday newspaper. If you don't, come on down to the office. I'll provide you a copy of mine. And we're going to talk about some parts to this article as the week goes on, break it down even further, and see if we can get a better idea of what's really popping. All right. Everybody have a good night. We'll see you tomorrow. Tomorrow will be the last day of September. We'll be on fall hours, so we'll be here 9 to 5, which means Frisbee Golf will be back in my future. And also, just like our office, public information office officer said, if you're a patient out there, be careful. I would advise you to consult a private attorney before following what this article says. They might want to consider following, you know, researching that information a little more just before they start throwing state residents under the bus. They won't protect us and give us safe access, but yet we have an officer telling people to order seeds from another country over the internet. Wow. Wow. Baffled. It's been a rough Sunday. It's been a rough Sunday, but we'll get back on this tomorrow. Everybody have a great night. Once again, this was Sunday, August 30th, 2009, and this was your Daily Dose.